Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Thoughts from the Kitchen Table. My name is Jennifer. Ever since this pandemic has begun, we've heard the same slogan over again, haven't we? We've heard stay home, stay safe. We've heard it from the government. We've seen it in people's gardens, on front windows. We've seen it on motorway bridges. We've seen it everywhere. Even now when we have a conversation with people, how do we end? God bless, stay safe. In emails, we end it, stay safe. Even the occasional letter ends with stay safe. Now our schools are opening and our churches are reopening and our workplaces have reopened. And our concern is trusting people to keep their environment as safe as is possible. This morning, I want to look at a psalm that I've looked at a good few times over lockdown. And it talks to us about the ultimate safe place. This psalm is found in God's word, Psalm 91. It speaks of God's character, of his protection, of his strength, and his love for us. I'm not going to read all of it, but I'm going to read some verses this morning. I'm going to read Psalm 91, verses 1 to 5, and then verses 14 to 16. And here's what it says. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. And then verse 14 says, because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. I love this psalm. The psalm writer tells us what we need to do in verse 1. He tells us that us as believers, those who have trusted in the Lord Jesus Christ, he says we need to dwell in the shelter of the Most High. We need to saturate ourselves just with the lovely presence of God. That word dwell just means to live or to reside. So really, every moment we should be living and residing in the presence of the Lord. If we have trusted in him, his presence surrounds us every day, every moment of every day. And we can dwell in it, whether it's out walking through the woods and seeing God's wonderful creation in everything around us, whether it's just in the everyday moments of our lives, we can savor the presence of God and we can shelter there and feel it surrounding us no matter what. What is a shelter? A shelter is a place that protects us from the storm, in the storm. Have you ever run out of a shower of rain into a doorway? Have you ever run into a bus shelter or somewhere like that to stay dry? The storm keeps going on around, but you're safe and dry in a safe place. You know, that's what God is for us as believers. The storm may still roar around us, but we find shelter in him, in his sweet presence every day, no matter what our circumstances are. I don't know what your circumstances might be this morning, but today you can shelter in his presence. Even though your circumstances might be roaring around you, you can find peace in the shelter of the Most High of our God. I trust that you will find peace today in the shelter of the Almighty, no matter what circumstances you might be going through. The second half of verse 1 also tells us that we need to abide in the shadow of the Almighty. To be in somebody's shadow means you really have to be up pretty close. Maybe sometimes we see a child follow their daddy or their mommy around, and they'll say to us, oh, he's just like my wee shadow. He follows me around all, everywhere I go. You know, God wants you and me to abide in his shadow. That word abide just means to stay there. not flit in and out whenever it suits us. Sometimes whenever we're in trouble is when we decide that we want to be close to God. And then when things are going well, we're farther away again. But God says he wants us to abide there. He wants us to stay there in his presence. He wants us to talk to him. He wants us to read his word. He wants us to be close to him every single day. You know, God loves you so much that he longs for you to be close to him. I love the next picture in this psalm. In verse 2, it says, I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress. Again, what's a refuge? A safe haven, a safe place, a place where we can run when we need help. You know, sometimes when we as Christians even go through troubles and problems, we find refuge or we look for refuge in everything but God. We go to other people, lots of people sometimes. But God says, come to me. I'm your refuge. You can hide in me. You can hide in God this morning and find refuge in him. He's our safe place every moment of the day. I love the picture of a fortress too. It reminds me of a trip a couple of years ago that I took to Edinburgh for a week. And everywhere you go in Edinburgh, you see Edinburgh Castle from every point. I'm sure in its day it was quite impressive, an impenetrable fortress perched up on a hill so the enemy could be seen coming. You know, you and I as Christians have an enemy, and this enemy seeks to shake our faith. He seeks to make us doubt in God's goodness to us, especially in these days. But you know what? We have a secure fortress in our amazing God. If we hide in him, he will protect us from the attacks of the enemy and keep our faith strong and sure. I trust that you will know this strong fortress today and that God will keep you firm in your faith and in your walk with him. So far, all the pictures in this psalm have mirrored strength and security. The next picture does that as well, but it also speaks of God's love. Verse 4, he will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. You know, this is a lovely picture, isn't it, of a mother hen or a bird sheltering her young. It reminds me of a story that I sometimes tell the children, the little red hen, of a farmer who had a little hen who lived in the barn with her chicks. And one night, sadly, the barn burned to the ground. And the next morning, when the farmer went out with his stick to poke around the remains of the charred barn, there he found the body of the little red hen. And as he poked at her charred remains with his stick, out from under her wings came scurrying all her little chicks. This little red hen had sacrificed her own life, covered her chicks and kept them safe. And that's a picture for us of what the Lord Jesus has done for us. He loves us so much that he sacrificed his own life on the cross for us. He gave his blood for you and for me, so that we would never have to face the punishment of our sin and we would be safe. That's what God's heart is for you this morning. Maybe you're not a Christian this morning. Maybe you've never come and trusted the Lord Jesus to be your Savior. But he loves you so much. He's calling you to come under his wings. It reminded me of another verse in Matthew chapter 23 and verse 27, when Jesus looked out over the city of Jerusalem and he wept. And this is what he said. I would have gathered your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, but you were not willing. The people of Israel were not willing to trust God. Jesus wanted to gather them under his wings and to love them, but they didn't want that. And that was their downfall. This morning, God longs for you to come under the shelter of his wings. He longs to give you forgiveness for your sin. That's why he sent his son Jesus to die for you. I trust if you don't know him this morning, that you will come and put your faith and trust in him and come under the shelter of his loving care and know what it is to have him in your life. He changes his tone in the psalm. He starts off talking generally about those who trust in the Lord. But then he makes it really personal in verse 5. He said, well, knowing all that, knowing that God is your refuge and your fortress and he wants to put you under his wings, then it says in verse 5, you will not fear. This should fill us with strength and courage, shouldn't it? No matter what, we don't need to fear. I have to tell myself that as well. I certainly haven't got it just right either. But no matter what, if we stay in the Word, if we stay talking to God every day, He will fill us with courage and boldness. And the more we get to know Him, the more we will trust Him for our lives. The end of the Psalm, verse 14 to 16, really is a list of wonderful promises that God makes to those who love and trust Him. It actually says in verse 14, because He holds fast to me in love. So in other words, if we hold fast to Him, if we cling on to Him in love, here's what He's going to do for us. He's going to give us deliverance. It says, I will deliver him. He's going to give us protection. It says, I will protect him. He's going to give us answered prayer. When He calls to me, I will answer Him. He wants to give us His presence. I will be with him in trouble. He wants to give us rescue and help. I will rescue him and honor him. And lastly, long life. What a list of blessings. And what we miss out on when we don't trust in God completely and fully. This week, if you've trusted the Lord Jesus to be your Savior, hang on to him. Stay in his shadow. Run to him when you need to. Hang on to him. Remember, he loves you and he wants you just to walk with him and to trust him every single day, no matter what is going on around you. If you don't know him today, I trust that you will come and find shelter under his loving care, his loving wings, and that you will come and give your life to him today. Have a really good week, everybody, and thank you so much for listening this morning.
He saves are his delight. Christ will hold me fast, precious in his holy sight. He will hold me fast. He'll not let my soul be lost. justice has been satisfied, he will hold me fast. Raised with him to endless life, he will hold me fast. Till thy faith is turned to sight, when he comes at last, he will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. For my Savior loves me so, he will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. He will hold. Hold me fast.